I think the problem I saw when I was thinking about starting a nonprofit tech company was, if technology doesn't make a lot of money, everyone is trained to not do it. See, Silicon Valley is all about making a lot of money with technology, but what if there's this great technology that solves a really important social problem, but it's not going to make anyone rich? So once you start thinking that way, and once we had the experience of making reading machines for the blind, I started thinking, well, what else might there be? And within 2 years of starting the reading machine for the blind company, I saw this human rights problem and went, oh, I wonder what Silicon Valley could do to help with the human rights problem of essentially people getting massacred and no one knowing about it.
So what was your train of thought and your action after that?
Well, you know, after reading about this massacre in El Salvador, which sort of got me thinking, thought, well, how could you protect a bunch of essentially peasants in a rural village? And the first thought is, you know, what kind of high tech could you have? Could you come up with a defensive shield or something like that? And not practical with today's technology, even if we could invent it. So started thinking about, what do human rights groups do? Well, all they do is process information. That's the only asset of a human rights group, is information about human rights violations. But no one writes software for them. So could we make tools to make the human rights movement more powerful by helping them do more with the information they have about human rights abuses?